Yeah, dear student, welcome back to the business study class. And today I am starting chapter 2, forms of business organization. And our topic is sole proprietorship. So if you remember in the previous class, I gave you the introduction about basic factors to be considered while starting a business. And here we are going to decide under what mode we are going to start the business. Clear? So there are almost 5 types of businesses available. First is sole proprietorship. Second is partnership, clear? Then joint Hindu family or Hindu undivided family. That's clear. Both things are same. Clear? Then our next topic is company, cooperative societies. So these are the 5 modes under which we can start our business. So today we are going to study the sole proprietorship only. Clear? So anyone is planning to start a business, clear? Or want to expand the business or diversify, means want to enter the new business. So what form of business organization is available? And we have to weigh the mode of doing the business according to the advantages and disadvantages attached to it. Clear? So various forms of business organization is available. Let us think one by one. So first we are going to discuss about the sole proprietorship. Clear? So sole proprietorship means, sole means alone or only. A proprietor means owner. So the simple meaning of the term is only owner or one owner. So this type of form of business organization is suitable for the small shops, not for a big shops. Small business, initially in their years of operation. Sole proprietorship refers to a form of business organization which is owned, managed and controlled by an individual who is the recipient of all profits and bearer of all this. As the person is the only one, so he has to bear the whole profit or loss. Whole profit and loss, and then he is the sole loss bearer. He is alone going to bear the whole loss. Clear? So now we are going to discuss about the features. Features of sole proprietorship. So see the first, formation and closure. First feature is formation and closure. So formation and closure of the sole proprietorship is very easy. There is no such legal complication or legal compliance is required. Just you have to register yourself with the local municipal corporation under the Shop and Establishment Act. Clear? Though in some businesses, proprietary business license is required, closure of the business can also be done easily. Thus, there is an ease in formation as well as closure. Second is liability. So as the alone person is the owner, he has to bear the whole loss arising. So the proprietor bears the unlimited liability. Unlimited liability means in case of loss, his personal property is also liable to pay the outside dues. Clear? Next, sole risk bearer and recipient. Sole risk bearer and recipient means as the person is alone, so he has to bear the whole risk. Clear? That person has to bear the amount of whole loss and whole amount of profit. Next point is control. So the business control of the business remain in the hands of one person only as the alone. So he has to do the whole planning and to actualize the whole of plans. Okay. Next, no separate identity. As I taught you the separate identity concept in the accounting, this means owner is separate and business is separate. But in the eyes of the law, there is no distinction between the sole trader and his business, as business does not have identity separate from the owner. The owner is held responsible for all the activities of the business, and even in case of a loss, his or her personal asset will also be held responsible for the payment of outside dues. Next, lack of business continuity. Now, what does it mean? It simply means if something happens to the proprietor or owner, if anything happened to that person, the business will come to the situation of halt. Clear? Business will not go ahead with another person. Clear? Because only is the alone person available. Now, what we will study is some merits. Clear? So, first is quick decision making. As the person is alone, he is not supposed to ask to someone else for anything. Clear? So he can easily take the quick decision, because he is not supposed to concern anything from anyone. Because he is the sole decision maker, he has to bear any profit arising from that decision or the loss occurring from that decision. Clear? Next, confidentiality. Your business secret will not come out, because as the person is alone, so he is not supposed to share his business idea with someone else. So the confidentiality of the information will always remain in your hand. Okay? Next is direct incentive. Incentive means some extra benefit. So whenever the business grows, the whole of the incentive will go to that person only, because he is the only person who is running the business and he is not required to share the amount of the profit with anybody else. So maximum incentive will go to that person only. Sense of accomplishment. Now, what does it mean? There is a personal satisfaction involved in the working for oneself. When you are working or doing any work just for the mental satisfaction of your work, this will give you a sense of life in your work for the success. It's not only contribute to the self-satisfaction, but also instill in the individual the sense of accomplishment and confidence in one's liabilities. Clear? Again, ease of formation and closure, so it's very easy. Ease of formation and closure. So it's very easy, because no such legal complication or licenses are required. Clear? Now we are going to study some limitations. So every business method has some merits and demerits. So we are going to study some limitations also. Limited resources. Limited resources. Clear? So what does limited resources means? As the alone person is bringing, so it has some caption or the capture on the amount of the capital brought in by that person or the working ability of that person. So there is a limited resources. Clear? So what that person will possess? The limited amount of the liability. Limited amount of capital and resources, working experience, everything will be limited. Clear? Second, limited life of a business. If anything happened to that person, the business will come to the situation of the halt or to be get finished. Now, so it is controlled by the one person. So if that person suffers from any diseases, mental illness, any accident, the person becomes handicapped, the business will come to a situation of halt or a closure. So sole proprietorship possesses the limited life of the business. Then unlimited liability. As from the legal point of the view, there is no separate identity. Clear? As we have studied already, there is no separate identity. Means business is not separate from its owner. So in that case, the personal asset of that person will also be held responsible for the payment of debt. And limited managerial ability. Person will possess very less amount of the ability.
Yeah, because he is the alone person, so he can't be expertise or having an specialty in every aspect of the business. So that person has to take the responsibility of varied managerial tasks such as the purchasing, selling, financing, etc. And it is rare to find an individual who excels in all those areas. It is very difficult that person possesses the skill of all those areas. Clear? So I hope these things will be clear to you. It is enough for today. For any doubt, feel free to contact me, message me. Thank you.